Hello and welcome to another episode of my Getting Started with Todoist videos. This episode is all about notes, adding notes to a task. Now, this is actually sometimes very, very useful when you have additional information that you want to actually collect in a task. And you can use the comments section. It's actually called comments in Todoist, but really you can consider it notes. And also you can actually attach files. You can also link your Google Drive, your Dropbox, also to your actual Todoist, which is really, really useful if you're using any of those cloud services. So that's what we're going to show you in this episode. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. So let me take you now into my demo account and show you all you really need to know about creating notes. Okay, so let's go into a task. So I'm going to go into my morning routine here. And with my morning routine, this is a task that normally you would have a number of things that you want to follow in the morning routine. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add comments. Now, there's a couple of ways of doing this. For me, one of the best ways to do it, because you get the syntax, is to just create a list in a notes app, as I've done here. I'm going to copy that and I'm going to go into here and I'm just going to add a, just paste that in. When I add the comments, you'll see that I actually get the bullet points. And you can do that simply by just adding a star and then space and let's say reflection as another one. I'm going to add the comment and you'll see that I actually get the syntax. So you create the hashtag and you can create the hashtag. So that's my like one way of getting tasks or comments into your tasks. Now there's a couple of other things while we're here. What you can do here is you can actually edit it by clicking on the edit function there, and I can add more, and then you click update. I can delete it. So let's go down to this one. I can delete that and delete it. And I can add a reaction. So this is really more for when you're doing collaboration with other people, you can actually add a reaction to that. Now, more on the comments or notes is you can actually add files. Now, if you have a Dropbox account, you can connect your Dropbox account. If you have a Google Drive account, which I guess most of us does, you can connect your Google Drive. And what will happen then is you can select files from those drives and just add them into the comments. That way it will open up the file in the actual drive, which means that you're not keeping a kind of spare copy. So you end up with lots and lots of copies. You've got it direct in the actual drive itself. You can actually drag and drop files. So let's just go into here. Sorry, I just click on here. Yep, we're going to down to here and go into my archive drive. This is my demo account, so I don't really have very much there, but let's just go into here and see what I've got. I'll go into this old materials. Okay, I've got one there, which is a PDF. So I can just drag that in, drop the PDF in there, and that will upload to Todoist, add the comment like that. And now that file is openable. All I have to do is double click on it and open it. I would do to show you, but this has got some personal information in there, so I will just leave that there. But you can actually create, add files directly from your computer. You can also do this from your phone as well. But as I said before in the previous episode, I will be showing you especially what you can do there. So it will always show you how many comments you've got in here. And if I click out of that now, what you'll see is I get this little these little check marks. So I've got one here, so I can click on that and it'll take me straight to the comments in there. I've got one for taking garbage out. I have no idea what that would be. Okay, there's another one where it's just showing you where I put a PDF file in there. So really that's all you need to know about adding notes. You can also do syntax. So let's go back into my chore one here. I can actually use the normal Todoist syntax. Now, I haven't shown you how to do this yet, but if you wanted to bold something, you do double exclamation mark, and this is important, and double exclamation mark, and add the comment, and you'll see that it's actually bolded. So if I go in there and then just sort of add a return and say this message needs a reply. Update that and you'll see that this is bold and that. So you can use syntax, but I'm going to show you how to do that in a later episode. But those are just some of the things that you can do with your notes. So you can drag and drop files, you can connect your Google account there, and that will work. I would be able to show you this, but unfortunately, because my browser is not working correctly, this doesn't work at the moment because I'm having problems with my internet. We have a storm overhead at the moment, so that's not working. And I can add more reactions, and this is a bit more like emoji right there. So there you go. That's just some of the things that you can add directly into Todoist. And this is also, by the way, with the voice memos, you can do that also from your phone or from your iPads or whatever. They're all available. So you've got some really useful tools there for when you're adding notes. So hopefully that's been useful for you. Just again, as a little reminder, Notes is a premium version feature. So if you don't have premium, you won't have access to your notes. And a lot of notes become really, really useful when you're collaborating with team members, which I will be covering in a future episode. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently, I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.